Okay, so I am going to run a basic lunar mission. I just felt like recording it for the hell of it. So you guys will get to see. We're gonna run an Apollo-style mission to the moon, complete with a separate lander and orbital docking, all that fun stuff. Hello, come on in. You get the door. Yeah. What? No. So this is the craft I've got. It's pretty sweet. Couple of interesting things. No solar power. It's all batteries. So we have a very limited mission window. And there's a lander in there. Unfortunately, I think I'm going to have to change how these fairings are set up. I guess that's a plus. Profile that will go into orbit first and then we'll boost out to the moon. Oh, also, neat thing, working escape system. Check this out. How cool is that? Safe and sound, just in case our rocket explodes on launch.
A lot of the enemy tribes, the bad guys, the more like
let's do this for real. Also, check the sound of this rocket as it fires up. It's kind of amazing. We're at full power, release, and we're off. Give us a little bit of inclination to start with, just to clear the pad. Back. There's just no point in going faster than this, this low in the atmosphere. We'll start to come over towards 45 degrees. We're approaching 10 kilometers, so we'll throttle back up. Good. 50. We'll try a 75 kilometer orbit just because I don't want to waste more fuel than we have to. Also, this engine does not shut off instantly. See, it's still producing thrust. It takes a while. Alright, let's plan our orbital insertion. Well, not orbital insertion, our orbital burn.
This
rocket is ridiculously powerful.
One with Wii motion plus inside.
That might be my one, but I'm not 100% sure. So take it, and if you didn't, bring it back. Because I haven't touched the thing.
Oh, no way!
So, like, you have a different one.
Right. 85, 205.
Turn this one final daily. It's the, like, one daily that I've found interesting to do. It's the, like, Sunday fishing challenge.
You should get your headstone, though.
Alright. So we'll start.
I do like telling people to get that. I also explain pretty much everything.
That's right. So we have 34 second burn.
I have a death knight.
And we're gonna run out of fuel on this stage before that burn is complete, so I'm gonna start it.
I mean, I don't love it.
A little early.
It's
this thing is almost...
I mean,
oh, this thing's gonna, like,
kind of like
turn off instantly. Need ferrum anymore, we're out of the atmosphere. Disconnect the escape system. And alright, let's start our burn. Oh, no! Shoot. Well, we just knocked off our. We knocked off the docking clamp, so we're gonna have to restart.
What's up?
Oh, no, I'm
Okay. All right. Take two. Passing through maximum dynamic pressure. Right.
Auctioneer, I know, is a really good one.
Okay.
I have some of these downloaded, and in theory, working, but...
Let's try this now.
I don't know how to turn any of them on.
If you go back.
It's like Altaholic is one that I want to work, right?
Hopefully, that will end up on enough of a different track.
Yeah. Do you have it already?
Yeah.
When you download? Okay, go back and see, get Fishing Buddy and Atlas Fire.
We'll go out to 80. 80's good.
And then it's not supposed to fall.
Fishing Buddy.
Gatherer, I think, helps with node mapping and stuff.
Yes.
Gatherer is.
Perfect. Get a 34 second burn. And this is gonna decouple almost instantly when we do it. See the docking ring. Getting out of our way this time. Not smashing our spaceship up. Seconds, I think, should be good. Just want to make sure we have enough leeway to fine tune, and then it'll have to adapt to the lower thrust. This one's out. Oof, we're going to be a little late on this burn, but that's okay. We'll get it to orbit. Periaps will be a little lower. Not by all that much, really. Making up ground fast. Again, gotta remember this engine also takes a little while to spin it down, so as soon as this hits about 50 meters per second, I'm gonna kill it. We're in an 80 by 90 orbit, that's fine. Plenty of fuel to boost the moon. So let's do inclination correction burn at the descending node. Should be a very small burn. Perfect. We've got 15 minutes to the next burn, so I can set up my displays. I love that they put the enhanced nav ball in this output. It's awesome. So radar graph, not super useful right now. We can do our orbital information navigation information. This is our orbit information. See, we're at a 90 by 80, inclination 0.337. Here. You can see our vehicle mass, acceleration, stage delta V remaining, and efficiency. Temperature of the craft. Even tells you the biome, that's awesome.
Yeah, no, it's
I can turn off air. Okay, cool. So.
Yeah.
KW Rocketry, guys, it is sweet stuff. Actually, I'm gonna be able to find my nav node easier from here. We'll use RCS. Let's try to save our batteries.
Yeah, it looks like
You can see me tweaking my inputs here. And I am using the time warp trick to kill my rotation because it's easy. Alright, so I'm in position. We can warp to burn. This is gonna be like the tiniest burn ever.
They're not foolproof, so maybe.
And we count, and okay, so, and like a bunch of them are in here that are not showing up.
Oh, as add ons? I think you might have to add them in the menu.
How?
Like the WoW menu. Isn't there an add on?
No.
Custom, what are the updates? All? Already on all?
Yeah.
Maybe you just have to drag them into the add on folder?
But they're in the add on.
They are.
Oh, Kerbin.
I don't need right. to, like, drag the things in those folders in there.
I doubt it. I don't remember having to do anything.
I just think that will probably be a nightmare to undo.
Yeah.
Ugh, too far.
Ooh, this one's only two.
Wait, one's good enough. So let's plan our burn. Maybe a daytime burn at least, that would be good. So I get a proper free return.
And you have to use the blizzard shell too, this time.
There we go.
Okay, that worked.
Oh, that sucks.
No, that I mean, it's still a little sucky.
You're gonna have to put a lot of stuff with it.
This is not a good one.
They're not bad, but they're not like this either. I'm not this either.
I see, I love their songs.
I really liked seeing Anthony Justin.
That was exactly who I was gonna just mention when I brought it up.
There we go.
Kind of there.
Yeah, I was
look at that. Look how awesome that is. The only problem with this is that we're currently going to impact the moon instead of flying around it. So let me see if I can tweak that a little bit. There we go.
Periapsis.
Persona 1900. Perfect. So this is going to loop us around the moon back to Kerbin if we choose. And if not, we could perform a breaking burn and bring ourselves into Munar orbit.
Have you not seen Dana's virtual reality moment?
Oh no.
Dana.
Yep.
Yep, what?
Yeah, you can play with it.
You're gonna have to help with that process?
I will, but I'm doing something right now.
Okay.
Thank you. Wait, is this not a decoupler?
Yeah, okay, PowerP PC applications will never support.
Oh god, it's not a decoupler.
Oh yeah, I knew what that was talking about.
There has to be a that's the thing, right?
There's got a
work. Alright, take three.
Yeah. I'm not just gonna chill with it. It's the worst company. And you know what? Everyone kinda saw this coming.
Wow, we did.
What is this? Just an adapter. Forward through this next part because we just did it, and we'll pick up in a second.
Thank you.
so we should be good now. Seconds to give us a little bit of room on the other side. Also, because our engines don't come on instantly. Yeah. I like to extend the burns a little bit because you get a lot more control. And with this giant engine, that's as good as I'm gonna get. So I'm gonna have to run a correction probably. Yeah, I'll run a correction when we're partway out. It's glitching anyway right now, so. Okay, so.
And this, I was trying to think of short names that people would get.
Alright. We don't need this giant stage anymore. Just a couple.
Yeah.
Now we just have our craft. So, we've got the lander on the bottom, and in here. Is our. Well, that was not exactly what I intended. Because that top is still on there. Alright, Langle. You're gonna have to go fix this. RCS. Now, how's that for a view? So I need Langle to be crewing this ship in order to pop that stage off. So I can... still stuck together.
Did you play games when you were like 14, 13?
What? Why?
I mean, the first console I ever got was,
You should not be stuck together anymore. Ugh. Maybe I can spin it off. Doesn't work. Well, crud. Yeah, I'm doing it manually. So that part doesn't even really exist anymore.
I have a physical one of those things, and I just
want to play.
We don't like
the
same game, so
I
like this game.
Ah, Kerbals.
Yeah.
I'm playing again.
Yeah, okay.
No, Final Fantasy VI has two female protagonists that do not have love for Jesus. Well, one of them kind of does.
Oh.
94. What is this?
That was all I needed. Okay. Giving up after this time if this doesn't work, because I swear to God. Thought I had this ship sorted out too. Just to show you how one staging issue is all it takes. Over a little faster here. I'll hit 45 degrees, a couple kilometers early, and we'll go to full throttle. See what that does for our fuel consumption. A little shocking. It's usually a sign that we're wasting gas. And we used more fuel by turning over earlier. Good to know. Bad. And we ended up in an 89 by 74. Could have been worse. That's our, we're gonna have to run a crash and burn. Thank you. again, this will be a little tiny burn. Just gonna trim with RCS because I have plenty of RCS fuel. Oh, okay. Good enough. And by good enough, I mean perfect. Periapsis of 40 is perfect. Let's aim for that. So the nice thing about this nav ball in the center is I can see all of the various maneuver directions, including a target direction, even if it's not on the front of the nav ball, which is awesome. Up. 22 second burn, which we're going to actually stretch it out. We're going to go at half throttle for that. So we'll fire at 22 seconds at half throttle. Just warp around to the day side. Go. Oh, right, I said half throttle. These rockets are not super accurate, but actually we are dead on. Nice. Okay. Gorgeous little free return. And now we can ditch this stage. Alright. Hopefully we can... Okay, good. And let's turn sideways. Set that as our target. Let's go to docking mode. And I am using the Navy Fish docking port mod because it's awesome. Closing in, our target looks good. Coming in a little fast. That's better. Beautiful. Look at this. Look how lovely this is. Boom. And we have a craft! We are on our way to the moon, and we have a craft. How cool is that? Let's warp to our sphere of influence change. If you guys don't know, with 32-bit KSP especially, you generally don't want to be in warp when your SOI changes, because that introduces the greatest possibility for error. You really want to be out, so I'm going to sort of run up towards this and drop out a few seconds ahead, just so we get as much data accuracy as possible in the simulation when we transit over. And this just means that the periapse that's projected is going to be the same when we change sphere of influence, hopefully. It's not guaranteed. You'll see this SOI change, perfect. Periapse is still pretty good. So I actually want to trim that a little bit closer to the moon because everything looks good, all systems are go. So this far out with an escape trajectory, we can actually tune where we come in by burning along the equator of the nav ball. So we're coming in on the west side of the planet right now. So if I burn east, it's going to drop my periapse. You'll see that as I do it. And this will work without actually changing our apoapse very much, because it's infinite right now. Oh, I should make sure the engine's turned on, huh? No, we're still in docking mode. And I think staging is still disabled, but looks like we're set up correctly. So, our hypergolic service module thruster is turned on, and I'm just gonna, I don't need a maneuver node for this, I'm just gonna bring this down to about 20 kilometers, and you see, as I was burning very slowly, like, it takes very little fuel this far out to trim everything. That's why they say you want to make your maneuvers as far away from your target as possible. And here, we're just going to set up a burn to put us into orbit. And this one's going to be a little big. Like, not crazy, but we'll go into a circular 20-kilometer lunar orbit. And that'll put us, like, not far above the surface at all. It should be very pretty. Just be zooming over it. Alright, 44-second burn. We fired the engine so it actually knows what the burn should be. look at that. There's Kerbin off in the distance. Moon's still far out. Not even sure. Oh, there it is. Alright. So we'll time warp in. And unfortunately, we'll be doing this one on the dark side, which is actually how Apollo did it. This burn was the scariest for ground control because they could not communicate with the craft while it was making this insertion burn. They just sort of had to hope it popped out in the right place on the other side. Which I think is actually awesome, considering this thing's running a CPU that had something like 16K of memory. Fire up our engine in just a second. And we're off. Good specific impulse on this thing, considering it's burning RCS fuel. Yeah, KW gives you hypergolic engines that work very well when you're not in atmosphere. And it's kind of cool to use them for this kind of stuff. It's even not terrible thrust, like 200 kilonewtons is decent. It's low for a 2.5 meter part, but that's... Sorry, just concentrating. Alright, we're in. We are in orbit. 20 by 20. Look at that. See as we come around to the day side, just how sweet this looks. Around noon, well, noon, around the middle of the day side of the moon, there's Kerbin rising over the horizon. How sweet is that? This game can be awfully pretty sometimes. Well, it's time to put some Kerbinauts in the lander. So let's do that. I think, Bob, as mission commander, you get to go first. And someday we'll be able to transfer crew without having to EVA, but I don't think that's quite working yet. And who else gets to go? Tomful or Lingo? Lingo. You look like you're happier to be here, so you get to go down to the surface. Fuel. I have not tested this lander out. It should have plenty of fuel for this descent and rendezvous, but you never know. So what do you guys think? What looks like a likely spot to land? At least relatively flat. I guess we can come down in the large southern crater. Probably the way to go. So, yeah. Actually, I think we can do this without having to go through another orbit. So let's do it. control from here. And undock. And we're down. We are a separate craft. Look at that. Plenty of battery power. And plenty of fuel. So let's plan our landing. We can actually come on a burn from here to bring us down. I am going to incline us down a little bit. I want to make sure we're in this crater. That's going to make it a little bit trickier to rendezvous because we're going to have to match planes, but I'm very okay with that. Let's turn our alright, engines engaged. Whoa! Stability, please. Thank you. Alright. Yeah, this is not going to take a lot. And we'll leave the service module, or the main craft in orbit. As we make our way to the surface. Gonna take us on the terminal trajectory. It's gonna put us down in the crater. My plan is to basically halt right there, kill all of our horizontal velocity. It's gonna cost a fair bit of fuel, but that's okay. And we'll come down in a controlled fashion from there. Closer. 3 kilometers up. Yeah, I like that. I'm just gonna have to make sure. Ooh, we're glitching. I saw this glitch before. It is very annoying. So what I'm gonna do is go back to the Space Center and reload. Nice thing in new version, it actually saves your maneuvers. So when I go back in, my planned maneuver should still be attached to that craft. Yep, you can see. You can actually see it there, which I think is awesome. It didn't used to do that. It was a huge pain in the butt if you had to jump out for whatever reason. All right, so we're still on approach. Everything's still awesome. Gear down. You're gonna see we're gonna come over this ridge and notice the crater stretching off. Mostly using this maneuver node to plan what I'm doing. So you'll see, I'm basically gonna go to the visual flight as soon as I kill my horizontal velocity, and I'm really just waiting for. Well, I don't want to be too late, or I'm just going to crash into the ground. I'm seeing ground scatter, so let's start burning. We're just hitting the brakes here, as hard as we can. And head. So I'm just gonna kill our horizontal velocity. And look at that, we're coming down. We're coming down actually a little fast. That's better. And I just wanna. Okay, so we're coming straight down now. I have a radar altimeter in the cockpit, but I can just use the shadow. Too fast. Good enough. And we're down. Just like that. We are on the surface. See our descent. Oh, it even gives you radar versus. Oh, that's so cool. Info. Cool. So, time for us to get out of the ship. Bob, your mission commander, it's your privilege. And I didn't put a ladder in just because they've got rocket packs. And there's very little gravity here. A flag. Done the old-fashioned. Neil will be proud. Okay. And let's get Lengel out here. Lengel, come on. Come on, the weather's great. Okay. Guys, look at how happy they are. They are just thrilled to be on the Mun. Well, mission accomplished. Time to head home. Everyone's aboard. Ooh. A little low on fuel. Huh. Well, this is gonna be interesting. So what I think I might do is I might just put this into orbit and then have the main module dock with us. Because otherwise, I'm worried that we do not have enough fuel. So, okay, we're gonna wanna burn west, not east. Just remember that. And off we go. Yeah, very low on monopropellant. Crap. Huh. That's bad. That's really bad. I don't even think we're gonna get into orbit with this. Yeah, I don't think I have 5 seconds of fuel left. Even 4 seconds. Well, we're gonna try. Hopefully we end up in orbit. I'm in. Totally messed up here. Well, let's see whether Lingle and Bob are making it home. I don't think they are. I don't think I have that much. Oh, actually, I can check. Delta V, it doesn't know because we're using hypergolic engines. Okay. Please, 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 please. Yeah. No! 25 meters per second short. Ugh. Well, for the sake of narrative convenience, I'm just gonna fudge this slightly. So we're in orbit. It's an eccentric orbit, it is not matching anything else. So, I'm gonna have to switch to here. And we have to do all the legwork in our main craft. So let's. We'll match plane first. Where's my next node? It's here. So this should match orbits. I want to go into a slightly higher orbit, just so that we end up having them catch up to us. As long as the inclination is right, this won't matter. Yeah, okay. We will 25 meters per second. That's just embarrassing. Should have put some lights on this ship so you guys could at least see it when we're on the dark side. That's a pretty shot, though. This is gonna be a very small burn. The timing is pretty critical. Thank you. Oof, too early. Okay, good, good, good. So we are gonna basically time warp for a bit until the lander catches up with us, and then we'll match velocities. You can see it's behind us, and every time we come around towards the apoapse, it's gonna gain on us. Hopefully it won't take more than an orbit or two. Looks like, I'd guess, 2 or 3 orbits. Yeah, one more orbit and I think we'll be really close. Kilometers, 38 kilometers, 1 more after this. Gonna pass under us when we're out here. Oh, that's a pretty good one, actually. Okay. So it's not quite gonna catch us. Where it is. It is. Alright. What's our separation here? 15 clicks. Alright. So we're going to match velocities. And I'm just going to use the nav ball to kill our relative velocities and then burn towards them. And thankfully, because we're in orbit of the moon, gravity is very low, these maneuvers are very easy. Okay, now I'm going to burn towards. And I'm just going to try and get my ascending indicator to be inside of the target indicator. And that means that I'm going to intersect. Except not really, because we're at such a large orbital difference, but that's okay, I can just keep adjusting. And you see that's exactly what I'm doing. Just increase my approach angle, or my approach speed. Oof! Look at that curve and setting. The other problem with this is we're coming around to the dark side, which makes this a little awkward. Will not lie. And then I am wasting fuel here, I admit it. I just want to get this intersect. Here we'll be at 6.4, and I'll kill relative velocity again. And that should put us on a much closer orbit. And it's just adjusting back and forth until we get really close. So from here, I kill her. Difference in velocity. Alright. I'll just burn towards again. Speed in. And I'd be in something other than map view, but because we're on the dark side, we're on the dark side of the moon, and I forgot to put lights on, all you guys can really see is the starscape. So, you can see the craft. 5 kilometers away and approaching, below us. I apologize, I'm just getting over a cold. Alright, and again. Kill our velocity.
Okay. I mean, there is an instance I've been meaning to do.
We could do that one, or we could do my favorite. You're bored, right?
Yeah, so you can do it.
So...
Alright, you notice when our relative velocities are the same, our orbits are the same. That's how it works. Scheduled to hit right there.
So
I'm gonna plan to kill our relative velocities before that happens. Gliding at 10 meters per second would not be advisable. I'm just gonna try to kill velocity and hold station until we get to the light side of the planet. Now we can wait till dawn. No point in doing this
honestly,
in the dark.
What I really want is my aquatic map, but
There we go. Beautiful. Gonna have to go around the lander because it's pointed the wrong way. I don't really feel like switching. Make it a little challenging here. See what I'm doing is I'm just lining up these lines. They represent the distance from target. And you can see my velocity vector is also reflecting how fast I'm moving away or towards it, so that when that's in center, like, I'm not translating in any direction from the thing. And the big circle is my actual alignment. Fuel. Oh well. So let's transfer some Kerbals. Like, strictly speaking, we didn't even have to dock there. I could have just stayed close and taken the Kerbals across EVA, but doesn't really feel like it's in the spirit of the thing.
Absolutely. I almost successfully soloed it with a different character.
No, you didn't.
I did. I choked on the last one.
You will play through it by yourself too powerfully, so you got nothing. So,
actually, that's not true. I got a pair of weapons because I was underpowered. Like, my weapons were underpowered at that point. So I was like, oh, I actually got the same drop twice within the same dungeon off of different characters, which seemed a little weird, but, you know.
Okay.
Not gonna complain.
What?
So let's just top up the batteries.
There's a wind rider, a fat person that I can take down closer.
Not from inside Undercity, it's outside of Undercity now?
No, there is one inside Undercity, but it's a pain to get down to inside of Undercity.
Nope.
It's just some
that way. Alright, let's plan a return trip.
Yeah. I got my course over there.
Oh, did you read Mog World?
I did.
I was gonna say, if you,
see?
Have it, you need to now, so that you, don't get stuck in a while after reading it.
Wait, I didn't mean that movie part of what got me. Why the fuck? Why not have this connected, then?
It might just be too far.
But I have down to here.
Yeah, but it's not this. It might be too far for...
I'm clearly dismissing this point.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, so annoying.
But the zones are cut up into four lines, so there might be a clear point, you know?
Oh, but there usually is. I think that in theory...
Oh, you'll fly past it all right.
Let's do this, and then it'll put me close to Apollaps, and I'll do a secondary burn here to come in. Yeah, I like that. I think that should be pretty good fuel-wise. We should have plenty of fuel for this.
But it's always a little weird to tell running it is.
Leave the lander behind in orbit.
Oh, I like the Arabian Highlands. They're just kind of chill. They're a good place to... No? See, that's the problem. I get the sense that I get something different out of these games than you do.
I've played this game too, that's the thing. I have played both games that I'm talking about.
And I'm sure you're better at them than I am, but like...
I don't think you'd be bad at these games.
Right.
And Battle Pass you can kind of be bad at. I mean, you
oops,
just
docking mode. Don't want to be in docking mode.
Therefore, then you don't really notice that, I guess.
Also, it shouldn't still be showing those engines. Those engines don't exist on this craft, but that's okay. Yeah, plenty of fuel. Well, not quite an Apollaps. Let's burn...
Yeah, this is my favorite instance. The second I can level up inside there, that's...
Let's burn here, and this should just take our parry ups down.
And the,
we'll just do this until we hit the atmosphere. We'll come in and... I'm gonna shoot for like a 20 kilometer... Cool.
I just don't feel like...
Oh, that's right. You hit those heart stones outside of them.
Yeah. That's for, like, a specific dungeon. I will try to do that someday, though. I just don't want to do it today. Because, I mean, it's a commitment.
Alright. It's SOI changed. We basically just ride the rocket back.
I'm
want to get really fancy.
Well, how much higher level are you? 20?
A lot.
Yeah, so just pick all the
shoot! And we just warped through. That's the trouble with time acceleration. If you're warping too fast, it doesn't even model you getting close to the atmosphere. It just puts you on rails right through. Alright, well, no harm done. Except to the laws of reality, which don't really apply anyway. Let's try it again. let's ditch this stage. Part. I don't have deadly reentry. I just have to land. You get to see Ferrum doing its thing. The capsule will auto stabilize just by virtue of the shape and mass distribution.
Because 500 life is the same amount of life. So if it's knocking you, if you're, it's knocking you down to 500.
Mach 9. Love how this goes. Decelerating in a healthy 5 G's.
Well,
as soon as we're below Mach 2, I'll deploy the parachutes. Gyroscopes, we won't roll down any hills. Coming through the clouds, too. It's a little time warp. Bob, not loving what he's doing. Alright, now we're down. It only took 4 tries and a little bit of cheating. But what have you. That's that. Later, kids.